Spent whole days out here.
Jake just caught a dang bass.
And this is, what was that, the third cast?
Yeah. A little bass.
Another bass, or not a bass, or yeah, it's a bass, but not another bass. I don't know what I'm trying to say. I caught a bass, that's what I'm trying to say. First bass of the day, hopefully more to come. Dumb.
Oh, that's my TV.
What is up, guys? 806 Anglers here, and welcome back to another video. And we are starting the trout season with a freaking bang.
With a fish!
Freaking, we are out here back in Dalhart, and as you can tell, it is super cold. I look like Buzz Lightyear, a Russian nesting doll right now. But we're gonna try to get on some fish. If you didn't just see just a minute ago before this one, he had caught a freaking bass out here. We're gonna go ahead and get started. So I'm gonna go get one of my other rods, start throwing it out there. Let's go ahead and get started and see if we can catch ourselves something.
Gonna throw this guy back out there. Dude, I don't even know. My stuff is freezing. Look at that steam,
well,
though.
Look at the net. Try picking it up. This is closer to the dock.
Look at that. It wasn't this cold last time.
No.
I had one. My line is freezing. It froze to the dock. Oh my god, I didn't think it was going to get this bad.
Like I was telling them, this is, when you dress for it, that's not bad at all.
Yeah.
5 layers, I feel fine.
I only got like a long sleeve and a freaking, this jacket. It's a pretty thick jacket. Mossy Oak jacket. Hashtag Mossy Oak, sponsor me. I'm mad I haven't caught one yet. Freaking Jake. Not sure if I want to go ice fishing. You say that and you're going to be like, first video in Wyoming ice fishing. Oh, really? Probably. I'm going to switch over to like a little plastic. I'm going to try a tube. I'm weak. Look at that. Straight tail frozen. Jake, look how frozen it is. Boom, tube is tied on.
Yeah, that's gonna work. He's got a downside.
Need to cover up my thumbs.
Oh my god, this shit's even casting anymore.
Oh my god.
Only feels warmer.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Dude, my line's so freaking frozen, it almost feels like I'm fishing with like wire line.
Yeah.
Like, what is that called? It's like aluminum cord?
Oh, lead cord.
Lead cord, yeah. Look at that, bro.
We can hammer a nail with
that. Oh, bro, that'll work. God dang, son, dude, I'm struggling. Might resort to a wacky rigged trout worm. Meanwhile, my first guide is almost completely frozen. We can't do anything right now. Like,
I don't know. I kind of want to go get an awesome streak.
I kind of need to screw my first fish for right now because
we have all day. They win.
You know how many people are going to be in the comments like, I live in Minnesota. I live in freaking Alaska. Fairbanks, Alaska, bro.
I live in Barrow, bro.
We don't even put the beers outside because it'll freeze. Bro.
Gear needs to get back in shape.
Give a look at that, huh? Almost every single guide is freaking frozen, bro. I know, mine are plastic. This is an older rod. Ted's probably laughing at us right now. Like,
he's probably saying, he's sitting by the fire. He's like, ooh, it's kind of hot in here.
Hey, Dad, can you turn down the thermostat? That's probably what he's saying right now. We're over here like, dang, bruh. Also, burrito, I'm getting mad.
Okay, you want to go?
Yes. Because my freaking... All right, so we're going to go get an also burrito. Maybe find some hand warmers that I forgot to bring. And because this ain't it, okay? And I'm also kind of hungry, so... That ain't gonna make matters better. These trout are flexing by just vibing down there. Look at that.
Yeah, Ted, you are one lucky person. I will tell you that.
Update. It's too cold.
Dual updates.
We're getting burritos.
I'm snotty at the moment.
We're gonna go get some food and try to warm up.
24. It's still. I don't think it's 24.
It's not 24.
I think it's
colder. There's no way.
It has to be in the teens.
I've never like been like, all right, I'm done. It's not even ice fishing in New Mexico.
Yeah.
Like, this doesn't make sense.
So we're going to see if we can catch ourselves some fish. Feels better out here. You got to be kidding me, dude.
I didn't say anything. On the dead devil.
You had a bite right there?
No, I'm playing.
I was about to say, bro, am I in your way?
Yeah.
Oh.
Not really.
Not really.
Am I in your way?
Yeah, I'm gonna go try my spoon. Going with the spoon. When in doubt, go with the hot sauce. Oh my god. Giant guy? Heck yeah, son.
That's what a fish looks like, by the way.
Yeah.
Usually I have more of Albert's days than vice versa. This is a very rare occasion.
Very rare. This is wild.
I'm trying to compliment you. Quit agreeing with me.
Go on. I'm no on the board.
Way. No way.
Finally.
On the Haas sauce?
Yep. Haas. Okay. Haas spoon, son.
Hashtag sponsored. Look at that.
Sheesh.
He finally caught a fish. Let's see if we can hit our first double. We can get some doubles on the board.
Yes, sir. Check that out, son. On a Haas little micro spoon. Get yours. Linked down below. Where's my forceps? I didn't put them on my belt. Let me use your forceps.
Oh, yeah.
Since you're right there.
Just staring at it.
Son.
There you go. Okay. If I catch a fish like this is going to be interesting.
Let's move over a little bit.
Oh, okay. I see what you're doing. Try again.
I don't want
to. Here, I'm going to recast while I have a chance.
I don't want to touch this. All right. We're going to just...
We can try that again.
No, it's fine. Peeling my drag. Alrighty. First fish on the Haas sauce. Good old Haas micro spoon. Yes, sir. That's what I'm using. Just a little golden micro spoon by Haas Fishing. Yes, sir. Just got these. I think it was last month. I knew they were going to be. Oh, God. Knew they were going to be fired. That was real. Real close.
I was trying to see if I can sneak one.
Yeah, I still had my drop shot tied on this one from when we went to Medi Park. Hey, yeah.
I figured that dropped a little too soon. Stay down, buddy. Actually, I really don't care if you just come off right there. Barbless hook, so do your thing.
This one actually took it. Oh, no, that's a treble hook, huh?
Yeah, you got both hooks in him. Top and bottom. Oh, no, he's got the one out now. So. Yeah, there's another fishy for y'all. Keep saying I need to stop, but then I don't stop.
That's what all drug addicts say.
Alcoholics Anonymous.
Alcoholics Anonymous.
There you are. Two for two.
Golly.
Oh, I was really hoping it was a... I'm really hoping it was a bass now.
He's like, now, bass.
Oh, this one's got them spots on him.
That's a pretty one.
Yeah, don't think we need to touch him. It would be nice if he just... flopped off right there.
Got another one. Yes, sir, on the Haas sauce. Good old Haas spoon. Yeah, it's a pretty one. Nice greeny. You know what I haven't fished with in a long time? A super duper. You never used a super duper?
I'm sure I have, but I don't.
It's like, it's pretty much like a spoon, but it's like built like this.
Damn,
it's like,
dude,
oh my bad. It's built like this. It's like, it's just a metal that's built like a long U.
Mm. And oh, it's like,
yeah. I haven't used those in so long.
Last time I used one of those, I used Jackson's for sunfish. He gave me one, and I was like, well, I'm just going to try it for sunfish.
I might put a trailer on this spoon. I did that in Utah one time. It was lit. Oh, okay, God, I got that. Hammered. He had us in the first half, not going to lie. Mm-hmm. They're really being stupid right now. Stupid in the sense of they're not biting like they should. Right here by the dog. Yeah, I think that's what I'm fixing to do. Got one. Yes, sir. My third fish. Let's go. I think this is my third. Just jigging the little spoon. Get off, son. Yes, sir. We didn't get any of those last time around.
Maybe that's our trade-off. It's like you can get nothing but trout and get a lot of them, or you can get a trout.
It's that guy that looks like Trevor Lawrence. He's like from TikTok.
Yeah.
Trade-off. You catch one bass and a few trout. You catch many trout, no bass. Well, you see, here's the thing. I like both, but yeah. Boom. Got this little crappie jig tied on. We'll see. I caught him on this last time I was here, so we'll see.
You know, what I wish I had was the breast cancer awareness jig. I remember that.
Yo.
My favorite lure.
That lure went hard here.
It did, yeah. And unfortunately, I don't have it anymore.
The heck? The one fish that was here wasn't this.
Doing bass like tendencies. I got some bass like tendencies in the rainbow trout fishery. I tried to make that rhyme, but that sucked. Sipping whiskey neath the neon moon. You listen to Hardy?
Yeah.
Hardy goes hard.
Yeah.
I want something sexy. So.
Are you gonna go to Powerbait? Oh. I was about to say, are you gonna go to Powerbait?
They like a little bit of that pause action. You can go.
Pink was the strat last year because I had like a pink jig also.
Yeah.
Got one.
Yeah, we did the.
Heck yeah.
Fish. He wanted the jiggy after.
Let's go.
That's a big one.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Wow.
Well, he's going in the cooler.
No, really?
No.
I was about to say.
Not yet. I'm not going to keep those till later. Got a good one. Probably my, this is my biggest one today.
Boom.
Come here, son. I'm trying not to touch this so my hands don't get cold. But man's doesn't want to. They mad. I know. I have no idea. So that's what I was using. Just jigging that guy. And he freaking crushed it. He liked it. Fluorocarbon. Fluorocarbonian.
Today, we are in Northern Ontario. Eh?
Thunder Mist Lure Company.
No. It's Linder's Fishing Edge.
Oh.
No, it's another bass. It's,
it's a bass?
Yeah.
Yo.
I was like, this kind of feels like a bass.
Look at that.
How did I catch two in one
a
day?
A second bass for him.
Yo.
Nice.
That's a pretty one.
Yeah. I was about to say, he did kind of look like he's built weird to be a trout.
So, that's kind of, I do have a little there. Let me try that.
This is what I was using last time. Is it this one? No, it's not this one,
that
but it's,
work.
It's the same color.
Dude, I am out of good hair jigs. I mean, like, think about this. Because I didn't think it would be this sucky fish.
Yeah. I'm trying to think what to put on this rod. I got one on the little, a little crankbait. Went to this little Rebel crankbait and caught my first fish on a little mini crankbait. This is the first fish I've caught in this crankbait. But heck yeah, I've gotten hits, but this is my first landed fish on it today. So that's pretty cool. Come on, son. Getting dangerous here. There he goes. That's kind of a terrible release, but he's off. All right, cool. See if we can catch another one on this little Rebel crankbait. Just casting it out there. Retrieving it. Yep, first fish on this little crankbait. It's practically brand new from a tackle box from a garage sale. So I'd say that's pretty lit. Slow, steady retrieve on these guys. Oh, got another one. He's swimming towards, oh, he came off. Bruh. Had another one, but he came off somehow. This crankbait's gonna do the work right now. Can we get another one? Come on, not that cast. Hopefully this next cast we can't. Come on, fish. Nothing on that cast. I think it's going to get into the, I think, almost 50 degrees.
Yeah, low 50s. It's supposed to be a nice day.
Yeah, it's just the morning was terrible. Got one. Yes, sir. Oh, that's a good one. No, that's a trout. Come look at it. It's a pretty good one. Ooh, that one's pretty. It's got like a pink side.
Really?
Yep. Really nice. Look at that.
Yeah.
It's a good one. Another one. Oh, yeah. I'll post this video, son. Ah, oh, come on, son. There we go. He's off. That's definitely probably the biggest one of the day for me. Sweet. Crankbait's putting in the work. Jakey might have to tie a crankbait on. This is the cove dreams are made of. I'm going to go try on this side. Yeah, I was going to say, too, if this is, if I do catch a bass, it's definitely going to be on a crankbait. Oh, I had a follower. See if I can get him to come back. Nothing. Move down here a little bit. See what I can do over here. Got one. Yes, sir. Another one on the crankbait. Oh, that's a good one. Another good one, Jake. God. Come here, son. God, this one's really good. Heck yeah. Another good sized trout. Heck yeah. Take a look at that. Come here, son. I'm trying to get this hook out of you. See, boss. Good size guy. I think I just found the strat for me, son. This is a little Rebel crankbait. You literally find these at Walmart, honestly. I've seen the bigger ones at Walmart and these little guys too. So if you want to try yourself out a little crankbait like this one. You got one? Oh, heck yeah. Jake just caught one. See if we can get another one on the board with the crankbait. Fishing crankbaits for trout is a lot of fun. Definitely one of my favorite ways to catch them. I think my most favorite would probably be inline spinner or a spoon for sure. Oh, got another one. Ah, had one. Almost had another one. See if we can get one this time. Actually hook them. Hook them all on the crankbait. One on the power nymph, orange power nymph. Let's go. Ah, rip. Well, there goes this little pinchers. I doubt they'll mind though. Power nymph, orange power nymph. Mm-hmm. Power nymph. Orange. You wanna look at it? I'm gonna go get the packs of freaking stuff. Right, we're set to go now. Power nymph, an orange one. Power nymph. An orange one. Why do I have so many rigged up in here? Like, I got a jig head on each, almost each one of them. Power nymph. Why do you keep wanting me to say power nymph? Power nymph, guys, for you, those of you watching right now, if you didn't know, he's in a power nymph.
Oh my god, I can see exactly
what's worms! I'm gonna pull the old Bill Dance.
Bill Dance. Bob Dance.
I'm sorry, Bill Dance. Should go to jail for that. Guess what? My power nymph is stuck. Power nymph. Look at that moose print.
A moose?
A moose? The Muffin Man! It's okay, I got a lot of rigged up power nymphs. Got one! Let's go! Heck yeah! Let's freaking go! Got another little guy on the dang power nymph. He almost just about freaking choked it. There you go, buddy. See you later. Oh! Had another bite on the power nymph. Dang. He goofed it up. Look at that. Got one. Let's go. Well, there's a little guy. He's small. He's a skinny little guy. Yeah, I really like this little area. It's like a little drop off, so the fish like to hang around here. Pretty good spot to fish.
Hi, kid. Oh, he's on the phone now. That's right up my alley. There is a trout.
Waving to y'all.
Really?
Yeah. Y'all seen trout before? Go home and watch a freaking blue marlin video or something like that. Alright. It's a bass. Film it. There we go.
It's a whole bass.
It's a whole bass. I never thought I'd say this, but I'm the largemouth legend. What kind of a laugh was that? What?
Yo.
Yo. That's my third one.
Look how chunky that thing is.
That is chunky. He's been eating some trout, you know what I'm saying? I don't know. He's eating something.
Look in his mouth, see if you see anything.
Yep. Tell me if y'all see anything, because I don't. I don't know where I was going with that. That was supposed to be cool. But yeah, northern strain largemouth. My third one of the day. Oh, this is a very rare day. I never caught this many bass out of here, you know?
Yeah, that's a beautiful, beautiful largemouth. And there he goes. Get out of here.
A little pink liner. I know, I'm going to get a lot of screen time now.
Got one.
No, wait. Double, okay, thumbnail time. Here, put the phone. Here, give me the phone.
Here. That's hilarious.
Mine's hooked good, so... Yeah, that's mine. Got a little pink stripe action there. And we got a double. So we finally got our...
We got a double!
And wouldn't you know it, we were just talking about how good the spot was earlier, last year. Now, we got a double.
That was real good. We going, we live.
Boy got the bass.
Guess who's got the bass? Oh my goodness.
Sir, the bass. Chunky boy.
Power nymph.
Power
orange.
Nymph. Orange.
Bassmaster. Finally found a nice little bass. Nothing down the mouth.
Yeah.
We're gonna release.
That's a dang near cookie cutter though.
Yeah. See you later. You know, you're right with the bass. Like, they don't bite. You just feel them on there.
Yeah.
Got another bass while the GoPro is charging on a power nymph again.
Oh, let's go. Got another little bass. That's crazy.
Yo. GoPro. And I'm using this little Rebel crawfish crankbait since that one bass had a crawfish in his mouth. And I've caught quite a bit. I don't think I've caught any on camera with this yet. I've caught a good amount of trout on this as well. I haven't caught any bass on it yet, unfortunately. But, I mean, it's working, so that's pretty lit. This is another crankbait that I haven't used. Oh, there's one right there. Heck yeah. Little guy. Going on the crankbait. Oh, probably should be careful. Hey, calm down, buddy. There we go. Just throwing it out there and reeling it in. They're hitting it hard, though. Like, really hard. I've caught some pretty good size ones on this, too. So we're just going to keep throwing this guy. I gave the power nymph a little break for right now, but we'll go back to it later. But as of right now, I want to keep fishing this crankbait because it's putting in the work. They're hitting it hard. Jake's over there throwing a red rattle trap, seeing if he can catch like bigger bass. Hopefully he catches something. That'd be kind of cool. So yeah, these are another one of those little crankbaits you get at Walmart. I see them over there all the time. And I've never really thought about using them because I was like, I don't know, this is kind of gimmicky. And then today I was like, well, you know, like I said, I found these tackle box at a garage sale. Practically never used. I was like, you know what, I'm going to give it a try. But yeah, that's what we got going on. This bait's practically never been used. Gave it a chance today, and it's putting in the work.
Did your GoPro crack online?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What the heck? They're not wanting to bite no more. Oh, there's one. Yes, sir. Right when I said they're not wanting to bite. Well, that's not a... Don't tell me this is the same one I just caught. No, no. This one's a little bit bigger, I think. Sweet. On the crawfish crank. One of the hooks has already bent out, unfortunately, but I wonder how long it's been bent out. That one right there.
Probably. That bad.
Nah, it ain't too bad. But I just realized it, and I was like, I definitely didn't just now do that. Come on, bite my lure again. Oh, my!
Oh, he did!
Big, my! Oh, my! Oh, Lord. The great Bill Dance once said, oh, my! Whoa, did you see that?
Oh!
I hope I got that on camera. That was wild.
Air trout. Freak Air Jordan, air trout.
We're talking about rainbow, son. Shoot, at least this trout has more of a chance of getting a ring than Mike Trout does. Rainbow trout.
I know he definitely said that.
Devin, if you're watching this, you know that's a throwback. Rainbow trout. No. Oh, I
got bit.
Golly. He hit that one hard. It was like 12 pounder. Really?
Yeah, I just got bit too.
Golly, hit that hard. Sheesh. God. Heck yeah. This guy fought hard for his size, to be honest.
Yeah.
Go ahead and just keep this one. Because he's a good size. So I'm just put him up here on shore and show you guys. Look at man's.
Hey,
Mom. Wow. But yeah, there's this guy. And Mance is gonna eat good tonight. See how long this guy is.
Hey, look how long this guy is.
He's almost 10 and a half. Oh, yeah.
That sounds a good one.
That'll keep. That.
That's bigger. What?
Yeah.
Okay. You wanna keep this one too?
Yeah, we'll keep it. Got another one, boy. Let's
Gosh,
go.
Dang, sorry. I know you did.
Yeah. That's a good
That's
one.
Where the concert is.
Yes, sir. I'm honestly surprised the game warden hadn't pulled up yet. Look at that big old turtle, he's back.
Power
nymph. Better not buy my power nymph forge. Yeah, probably.
Like salad on
there. Like salad on their nymph. Smoke orange. Got one. Let's go. Yes, sir. Oh my god, snogies. Never seen somebody get so hyped because of some snogies.
Yeah.
That's kind of funny. He just swiped at this one. Look, I hooked him on the outside of his, like on his nose. Ain't that crazy? Come on, come off. There we go. Decimation. So we're done fishing. Got the fish in the cooler.
Jake is driving, trying to back up and hit me. As for right now, my video is not over. We're gonna go clean these guys. So we will see you when we're back at the house and back in Amarillo. All right, guys, so we are back at the house and back in the kitchen. And what I promised earlier is the catch and cook. So that is what we are going to do. Got the trout laying right here in the sink, and we're gonna try out this seasoning. So what better way to start off trout opening season with the open season Cabela's trout and salmon season. So I'm gonna go ahead and clean these guys up. I'm not gonna show you that part because I already have a video on that. I'll pop it up somewhere up here. Then we're gonna put this stuff on there and just kind of put them on the grill, wrap them up in aluminum foil, stuff like that. All right, I'm trying to find some decent lighting out here, but I got the fish on the grill and we're cooking them now. And I think I'm gonna do 3 minutes on each side since they're not very big trout. So that's what I'm gonna do with those. And like I said, that seasoning is a seasoning that I haven't yet tried before. Hopefully it's gonna be good. It smells really, really good. So we're gonna go ahead and let these guys cook, take them out and then eat them. And I'll let you know what I think of the Cabela seasoning. Alrighty, I'm in the kitchen. Here's the trout. We got a little bit of skin piece on there, as you can see. That way we can get the whole flavors in there. So we're gonna go ahead and take a bite out of this guy. Not bad seasoning. That's pretty good. I like it, this is really good. This seasoning's really, it's got like a sweet taste to it, but I'm definitely gonna be making more trout with this recipe. Feel like I could perfect this recipe a little bit better, especially if I added the lemon slices on there. That would have been awesome, but I wasn't able to do that. I only had one lemon. I pretty much use it for all the trout. So other than that, it wasn't too bad. All right, guys, so that is gonna be it for the video. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and please do me a huge favor and make sure you subscribe to Jake's channel. I will leave it linked down below, but also make sure you check out Haas Fishing. He makes these awesome lures for me to use and he sends them to me, so make sure you guys go and check some of his lures out. Make sure you snag a few. These are really, really good lures. He makes them himself. You know, I've caught a lot of trout on these, but make sure you check out Haas Fishing. He will be linked down below. Once again, thank you Haas Fishing for sending me these lures and letting me use them. I appreciate you for that. Also, guys, if you are new, please be sure to hit the subscribe button, hit the bell notification, that way you won't miss when I upload. But anyways, guys, that's gonna be it for the video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Please leave a like on this video, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell notification, that way YouTube notifies you when I post another video, and we will see you on the next one. Tight lines, guys.